Can't ball in a life, man.
Ganja. Weed. Sensimilia. Marijuana. Cannabis goes by many names. Universally known, widely misunderstood. The journey from spiritual healer to heralded medicine to vilified substance is as remarkable as it is unfortunate. Based on a series of lies introduced and spread for the benefit of a malevolent few. Our mission in this documentary is to give you a full appreciation of cannabis, an understanding of its history, its present, and its very robust future. The use of cannabis for medicinal and therapeutic purposes can be traced back thousands of years.
My mother, she suffered from cancer, lung cancer. And when she got to a certain stage where the pain was unbearable, the doctors in Canada actually prescribed marijuana, and it certainly eased the pain that she was experiencing. So my understanding and my experience is that cannabis for medical purposes does work.
The ugly side of the marijuana industry is definitely all the restrictions that, you know, the cannabis plant has to face, and, you know, people within the industry have to go through to, you know, be a part of it legally.
My son, Macario Morgan, was born having uncontrollable seizures at birth. And my wife, who happened to be a scientist through Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee, created a formula for him. Growing up as a Rasta youth, and my father always talking about that cannabis is the healing of the nation. Now there's data, now there's scientific proof that I've seen through my wife that I've used a CBD formula to heal my son, which is missing 40% of his brain.
Police, search warrant!
It's only in recent history that cannabis has been prohibited and demonized.
My brother was arrested when he was 17 for $160 worth of street weed. And that cost him 10 years of his life in the penal system. Four of those years he spent picking cotton.
It is ironic that having served 30 years as a cop in London and also as a senior cop in Jamaica, part of my job was to go after cannabis and to arrest people for cannabis. And now, ironically, here I am in 2022, some 15 years later, and I'm protecting cannabis farms and I'm protecting dispensaries because I have a security company.
I had the opportunity to be a prosecutor. And I can remember vividly every Monday morning seeing lines of young men brought before the court for a spliff or two spliffs, and they had to either pay heavy fines, and sadly, some ended up behind bars.
As I said when I ran for president, no one should be in jail just for using or possessing marijuana. It's already legal in many states.
As more and more markets legalize cannabis throughout the globe, we have wider access to its tremendous healing powers. Even as we agitate to release the many still incarcerated for an ill-thought-out and racially motivated war on drugs, we see more research being conducted demonstrating the powerful medicinal benefits that originate from this natural plant medicine. We stand at a pivotal time in the adoption and development of this industry, which holds so much promise for the future.
You started all this shit.
Don't blame me.
Meet Douglas K. Gordon, the founder of CanEx Jamaica, the biggest international cannabis business conference and expo in the Caribbean. He got into the cannabis industry to provide a platform and make access to this incredible plant more widespread. He has welcomed industry leaders from over 40 different countries to Jamaica, and he takes great pride in ensuring that as they build the industry for the future, they allow themselves to be informed by its rich past.
One of the greatest things about cannabis is just the people it brings together. My entire life, I mean, it's always just brought good people together. Where will we go? violence has always been right direction, and using it has always bonded people into the general right direction of what we should do for our planet.
Meet Elvira Guzman-Barnett, the founder of one of the top publicity and event coordinating companies in Hollywood, California.
I got sick when I was 26 years old with an ovarian cyst, and I started to Google what kills cancer cells. So guess what? Cannabis is one of the things that kills cancer cells. And I started to consume cannabis in every way, every form possible, in addition to doing other things that also kill cancer cells that you guys could research. And the next thing I know, I got sick when I was 26 years old with an ovarian cyst, and I started to Google what kills cancer cells. So guess what? Cannabis is one of the things that kills cancer cells. And I started to consume cannabis in every way, every form possible, in addition to doing other things that also killed cancer cells that you guys could research. And the next thing I know, my body is healed.
After finding the benefits of cannabis, she decided to start doing VIP cannabis events in Beverly Hills to bring awareness to the magic plant. Now meet Elvira's parents, Manuel and Francis Guzman. Prior to Elvira doing cannabis awareness events, they thought that cannabis was a drug. But once attending her events and hearing the speakers, they changed their mind and started using cannabis for medicinal purposes.
A causa del cáncer y de la quimioterapia, y pues yo estaba muy preocupado. Y dije, ¿por qué no experimentar con eso, verdad? Y parece que le ha funcionado muy bien.
I had no appetite at all. I had no desire for food at all. And with that, I eat everything.
It saved my life from pharmaceutical drugs. Not having to worry and wonder. Is today the day that my kidneys may fail on me due to pharmaceutical drugs? I feel free knowing that I'm consuming cannabis and it's giving me a healthy life and allowing me to still be able to go for the dream and advocate for this amazing plant.
It's time to tell the untold story of the benefits of cannabis so the world can learn how to heal themselves.
Where will we go? Baby, are you feeling me? Cause I'm really feeling you. I'ma pull up in my fast car. Pull up in my fast car. Body's healing from that rock star.